Marina towards the port.
Sweetness, thanks.
Outstanding. 20 seconds to hand over. I'll catch you on the other side for the safety tether swap.
Sounds good, buddy. Oh my gosh, this is beautiful, isn't it?
Forecast to be double that of job growth overall. The programming pool will simply have to grow to keep up with demand.
Is it less than 20? No. Yeah. Is it equal to 40? Yeah. Do this. For one loop, then it's going to be 41. Is it less than 20?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Is it equal to 40? No. All right. Keep doing. Go out.
Right.
Last thing.
My name is Tanner Marcoita. I'm from Eastside San Jose, and I work for Campbell Middle School. The language of this area has a lot to do with being able to code. It's important to know a little bit about coding just to have a job. So it's become very important to me to help students grasp that. This is my first opportunity to take a crack at Zero Robotics, but this is very hands-on. I have this time with this choice and this mind to make a difference.
This is a robotics competition in which students program autonomous little satellites inside the International Space Station. With the middle school competition, we're trying to engage the marginalized, disengaged youth so that what happens is eventually we'll see a diversification of that pipeline. This is what your kids will be programming. The robot is the sphere.
Getting set up for the Spheres experiment that's about to take place on the space station.
Spheres, they are little robots. They are little satellites. They fly inside the space station.
As part of a competition, students write algorithms for the Sphere satellites to accomplish tasks relevant to future space missions.
There will be a code on station from California. Which of your team's code will it be? Who knows? And then will your state take the full title? Your mission is to build surveying satellites to orbit Mars. That is the space race right now.
One of the things that your satellite has to do is deploy three what we call satellite position system devices, or SPS devices, to find your assembly zone. Now that you've dropped your SPSs, there are some satellite parts that have been pre-deployed. You can see there's three types of items worth different amount of points. So part of your strategy is going to be deciding which items to take to your assembly zone. And the other thing is, once your item's in your assembly zone, it can be stolen. Another team can take an item out of your assembly zone. So another thing to keep in mind as you're...
It's kind of thinking of the strategy, all the possible, you know, hope for the best, prepare for the worst.
Right?
No pressure.
Yeah, right.
Okay. Yeah, the world is increasingly running on code, and this is a skill that our kids need to learn. It's also a skill that's not taught in school, yet it is something that is the future. So we really capitalize on the time during the summer for them to develop this skill.
Coding can be pretty unforgiving. If you don't put in the right code, it doesn't work. And I think that them being able to see inspirational stories about space and why we explore gives them an opportunity to be inspired in those moments where coding can get really tricky.
My name is Michaela. I am 11 years old, and I'm thinking of being a marine biologist. Tanner was just talking about it. He was explaining that it was going to be about coding. I've never done this before, and it just got in my head, and I wanted to do it. I think it's a good learning experience, too.
We're going to be able to simulate what our sphere is going to do, and it's going to show you what it would do in the actual game.
My name is Advik, and I'm 10 years old, and when I grow up, I don't really know what I want to do yet. I just think it's cool that you can make something from Earth go out and visit other places